and that's where we should start from. I mean, we've come out of COVID now, and everyone was hoping that, you know, 2023 would show some real growth. Of course, in terms of real GDP growth, it hasn't. But we are looking at PCB growth 2-3% this year altogether. So it's not been a disaster, but I guess people are lining up for next year to try and improve things. We're all suffering with, in Europe especially, the after effects or the continuing effects of the war in Ukraine. That came as a big blow to us in Europe. You know, we had hope last year to really begin a good recovery from COVID, and suddenly this disaster fell upon us, which has had big implications for raw materials, for energy costs and many other things. So, you know, that's the kind of backdrop that we're sitting in. Manufacturers have carried on, of course, manufacturing. They've come out of COVID now back into full-scale manufacturing largely. And we're expecting around 2-3% growth in PCB fabrication this year. And it does bring European PCB manufacturing back to round about the $2 billion mark again. So we dropped down to sort of 1.5, 1.6 billion during the COVID years, or perhaps 1.6, 1.7, and we're back to nearly $2 billion again now. So that's what we're seeing. Of course, one of the big issues that inflation brings is the difficulty for investment. You know, investment is required in PCB manufacturing and in the materials to supply that. And this never seems to end. You know, the digitalization of our business has caused, you know, big investments to be required.